What's up YouTube, JP here, and if you know anything about the Steam Deck, you will know it is an emulation beast. So in this video, we'll look at getting it set up. So without further delay, let's dive in. So installing individual emulators on the Steam Deck can be quite tedious. Well, I'm glad to say that EmuDeck has you covered. It's a one-click installation and it gets everything set up for you. So of course, some emulators are going to need a few extra steps. They might need a BIOS, or in the case of the Nintendo Switch, it might need some keys to get things up and running. But EmuDeck gets you 90% of the way there. Now, for the purpose of this video, we're not going to look at the individual emulators and how they run on the Steam Deck. I think that's best left for separate videos. But in this video, we're actually going to install EmuDeck on the Steam Deck. Then, in other videos, for example, like when we emulate the Nintendo Switch, we'll actually do a separate video going through the process and how to get the games on there. So I guess you could kind of think of this video as part one of a series. First of all, let's get EmuDeck set up, and then we can look at tweaking the individual emulators to get the best possible performance out of the Steam Deck. So let's jump over to the Steam Deck and get this set up. Now, I will tell you, I've completely factory wiped my Steam Deck, so it is like a brand new device. Just so, if you are doing this and you've never done anything before, like set up the web browser, we're gonna go through everything here. Sorry for interrupting the video, but I've got you a 10% discount code off anything on the Extreme Rate website. Now, they have some amazing products, just like this Atomic Purple Shell for the Nintendo Switch. They also have dock shells, LED light kits, replacement parts, screen protectors, you name it, they've got it. Use code ARG to save 10% today. So over on the Steam Deck, it has been factory wiped and I've signed in with my account. The first thing you're going to want to do is pop that SD card in. And now we're going to go and format it by going to Settings, then System, and you'll scroll down to Format SD Card. Now, this shouldn't take that long. It does have to do some testing before it does the format, and it also depends on how big the SD card is. Just be patient, give it some time, and then you should be good to go. Now, of course, once that's done, we need to go to desktop mode. So press the Steam button, go down to Power, and then switch to desktop. So as I said, it's factory wiped. So when you go to the Mozilla Firefox browser, it's not actually going to open the browser. It's going to ask you to install it. So once you've given it some time to load, in the top right hand corner, you'll see Install. So this will download the Firefox browser and install it for you. So that icon in the bottom left that we clicked before will actually then open the browser. So after a little bit of time, it will say launch in the top right corner. We're just going to close this and launch it from the icon itself to show you that it's now installed. Now, of course, you can plug in a keyboard or mouse or use a wireless one. But for the purpose of the video, I'm just going to use the built-in on-screen keyboard. Now, the website you want to go to here is www.emudeck.com. I'll also put a link in the description below. So once you get to the site, just click allow all on this. It doesn't really matter. You want to go to download, and then here you'll see the download installer. Just click on that and then hit OK. So once that's downloaded, you're going to want to open that file location. Should be in your downloads. And as you can see, this is what it's actually downloaded here. Now you need to drag and drop that onto the desktop just for ease of use. Now, of course, I am using the Steam Deck itself to move things around, so it can be a little bit tedious, but you can get the job done. So now we've got that on the desktop, you just want to double click on it with the right trigger and hit proceed. You'll have a command prompt here, and it will basically run through the first step of the installation. Now, after a few moments, you're going to get the GUI installation pop up. So I'm going to make this full screen and go through the process. Now you have two options here: easy mode and custom mode. We're going to do the custom mode just to show you all the options that you have available. Now, as soon as you hit continue, the first thing it's going to ask is where you want to put everything. Of course, I'm putting it on that SD card. Then it's going to ask you to choose your device. Of course, we're using a Steam Deck. And this is now going to ask you what emulators you want installed. I'm actually just going to install them all because I want to test them all. Hit continue. This is basically saying that it's going to update the configuration for all of these if you've already had them installed in the past. Just hit continue. So this option basically gives you the ability to do auto saving for the systems that are on the right. So we're going to turn this on. Now you can also sign in for the retro achievements, but for now we're going to skip it. Now this is a great option to have if you don't want to have black bars to the left and right on the screen. And it also shows you on the right which systems will be affected by this setting. Next, you get to choose the aspect ratio. Of course, I'm going to go for 3x2 because it just looks slightly better. Again, we got aspect ratio settings for the Super Nintendo and NES. I'm going to leave this at 4x3, the default. Again, more aspect ratio settings for the Dreamcast and Nintendo 64. 16x9 looks better. And again for the GameCube, 16x9 looks the best. Now this option is for LCD shader for handhelds. If you turn it on, it kind of gives you like a scan line. I don't like this, I'll leave it off. And again for the next two. Yes, I skipped ahead there. Let's go back. Yeah, I just think it looks so much better with it off. And then we have the PlayStation 1, Dreamcast, Saturn and Nintendo 64 CRT scan lines. Yeah, we're going to leave this off. Now we get to pick our theme. We have a choice of three. I personally like the modern theme, the one at the bottom. Now the last option is if you want to install some homebrew games. I'm going to keep that at no. Now it's going to use all those settings to set everything up. This can take some time, so we're going to fast forward the footage. So once you get to this screen here, everything's installed, but there is one last step we need to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to close this down. And then we're going to double click on that file that we clicked on earlier on to install EmuDeck. Of course, you're going to get the same pop-up, but this time we're going to click on Tools and Stuff. Now we're going to click on Steam ROM Manager. And basically what this is going to do is allow us to have certain emulators and games on this Steam home screen when you're in game mode. Now, of course, you don't have to have the settings I have. This is just a recommendation. But where you see parsers, we're actually going to turn that off, because we don't want to see every single game for every single emulator showing up on our Steam homepage. So we'll turn that off, but what we do want is we want Emulation Station and the individual emulators themselves. If you turn any of the other ones on, it will not only put the emulator there, it'll also put every single game that's in that emulator. So now we're going to click Preview and then Generate App List. As you can see, it's going to fetch all the images for Emulation Station and all the other emulators. Now, I like to have it as posters. I just think these look quite a lot better. Now, of course, some of the posters will have multiple pictures, so you can actually change them. I did try and change the Yuzu one, but it looks kind of the same. But if we change the Ryjax one, you can see that there's quite a few different posters here. I quite like this one, so I'm going to leave it at that. Let's have a look at what the PlayStation 3 pictures look like. Yeah, I think I'll keep that one. The XEMU is obviously the Xbox one, so I wanted to change this to look more like an Xbox. There we go, Xbox logo. I think the last one I'm going to change is Emulation Station. That looks a bit boring. So does that. No. This one looks pretty cool. We'll go for that one. Now to save all the changes we've just made, we just hit Save App List. And what this is going to do is transfer everything we've just done there to the Steam Deck game mode screens. We'll take a look at that now. Right, so we're back in game mode. And as you can see, it shows me some recent games. But if we go to library, this is where we're going to see those new apps we've installed. So if you go across to collections, you'll see we have 16 emulators in there. And then if you go to non-Steam, which is your non-Steam games, you can see all those lovely tiles we've selected. And obviously clicking on these would open the emulator itself. So as you can see, it's really easy to install EmuDeck, and I do recommend it to anyone that's got a Steam Deck. Just think of the amount of games you could have for all different systems, all in the palm of your hand. Now, of course, I installed everything on the SD card, and I'll be putting all the ROMs, ISOs, NSPs, whatever, on the SD card. Now, I do have a 512 gigabyte NVMe internal storage, but I want to keep that for the actual Steam OS and the games that I download off Steam. So I do recommend putting everything on an SD card. Now, one thing we didn't go over is actually putting games on that SD card. And unfortunately, you can't just plug it into your Windows PC or laptop to transfer them across because it's a Linux partition. Windows just won't recognize it. So in the next video, when we look at our first emulator, we'll actually go through a few different ways to add those games to the micro SD card. So I'm going to end the video here. If you enjoy my content, please like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads. I'm JP, you've been watching Alien Retro Gaming, and I'll catch you in the next one.